So now that we learned how to use text, let's get a bit more fancy. The first fancy thing is that now we're going to start using the word string. You might think, string? That's what my cat plays with. But for programmers, string is a special name we use for bits of text. You can think of it like a string of characters if it helps. Your name is a string, your school's name is a string, and every text message you've ever sent is also a string. Basically, just think string equals text. So, we use drawing and coloring with strings already. Can we use variables with strings? Of course. Just like you might normally put a number into a variable, you could also put a string into a variable. We just say something like var my name equals whatever your name is, so Sophia, remembering those quotes. And then we put the variable my name into the call to text instead of writing Sophia directly like we were doing before. And this way, though it looks the same right now, we can actually write this multiple times, you know, one time there, you know, maybe we're a little bit egotistical. And then all you have to do is change this one variable to be your name, and then you have your name written three times. So, just flipping that back, what if we want to get kind of crazy? Can we start adding together strings? Like you remember when we maybe started adding together variables? Well, we can actually do that. The computer will just stick the two strings together. So, for example, you know, we can get rid of this to do it only one time, and then we can use this other variable message that's going to be my name plus, say, a bunch of exclamation marks. And if we stick message into text to draw this variable instead of my name, we can see that all it did is it just stuck those exclamation marks that we had onto the back of my name. And we can even make this a little bit more exciting if we wanted to write message, say, twice. So this looks pretty reasonable. You know, adding strings means you stick one string onto the back of the other string. But you might be thinking, could we get really crazy and start multiplying or dividing or subtracting strings? Could we do that? Well, no, we can't. With strings, we can only add them. You're right that we could divide and subtract with number variables, but string variables only allow us to add. But still, being curious and asking those sorts of questions is the right attitude in programming. You might think, what would it mean to divide a string? So, we can also use animation and mouse interaction with text strings. For example, we can make the string follow the mouse around just by sticking it in a draw loop like we did with rectangles. So, if you think about how to do this, we'll just say var draw, and then we'll stick all of this right in here. And this probably looks really familiar from intro to animation. And you might think, all right, well, to make it follow the mouse around, we certainly need to use mouse X and mouse Y, and there you have it. We're actually painting with our name. And of course, if we wanted, we could easily set a background, say to, you know, a nice light blue, and now we have that the text is just following the mouse around, just like we saw with the rectangles. And now, as a last fun trick, let's use animation and make the text size grow and grow and grow. So here we're setting the text size to 30. As we learned in variables, instead of using 30, we could also say var how big equals 30, and then use this variable instead of doing 30 directly. Well, so that's the exact same thing, and we need to obviously be changing something in order to get animation. So we can do that by saying how big equals how big plus 1, which actually means, if you remember, how big gets, you know, how big it was before, plus 1 to make it a little bit larger. And now we just need to restart the program. And here we have that as we're moving the mouse around, the text size is growing and growing and growing and growing because of this line right here. And, you know, just on your own, you might think, okay, how can we make it grow faster? So now, not only do you know how to manipulate shapes with code, but you can also use text with code as well.